Welcome back to The Observation. I hope everyone's having a great week. This week's show, we're going to be discussing modern consumerism and how things you may own may start owning you. And we're going to discuss Euro summer. It's that time of year again where your Instagram feed is just full of vacation pics, you're bombarded with weddings, all kinds of stuff. We're going to discuss that. But this show, we're just going to dive right into it. This week, I joined a friend's discussion, my friend Harry B, who is a legend out here in New York and also in Hawaii, and he's building an AI app called Sessions. And so we had our own session in Tribeca where we explored a scene from the movie Fight Club. If people are familiar with the scene from Fight Club, it's where Brad Pitt's character is talking to his friend at a bar and they're sitting there and he's kind of asking his friend questions because his friend's like down on his luck. And he says like, what are we? His friend says, we're consumers. And he's like, exactly, we're byproducts of lifestyle obsession. This whole prompt is really interesting because basically at the end of the scene, he goes on to say, the things you own end up owning you. And so this was like our prompt within this group of people in this session in Tribeca. We had kind of like candles lit in the middle and everyone sitting around talking about what that personal statement means to them. So what does consumerism mean to them? Originally, when I was thinking about this, and originally when this film was created 20 years ago, I was critiquing consumer culture and material possessions. It's interesting now to put that scene into the lens of 2024. So let's apply that to the digital age and to social media and technology. I was just sort of thinking about how algorithms own us today and social media platforms own us today. It's crazy because the consumer part of it didn't leave. We are consumers. When marketing companies think about us and when they're in their meetings, their big boardroom meetings, they're thinking, what does the consumer want? What do they want to consume? And it's so gluttonous. It's so gross. In terms of technology, that is how the algorithms are thinking too. They want your attention. This is the attention economy. The next step in that was thinking, wow, social media platforms really can and do own us, not only in just our time and attention, but in the way that we interact on there. If we are getting validated for certain viewpoints and certain likes, and that's getting rewarded, well, that's feeding its own loop in your brain. You're getting that reward, that release of dopamine in your brain. That's feeding you back into, well, I should keep producing this type of content more. And what I also loved about this scene is that in this scene, Brad Pitt's character says, I say never be complete. I say stop being perfect. And I think that's really great to remember that we don't need to consume everything that's thrown at us, including all the influencer hauls that we see all the time of like, this is the trend now, it's mob wife era, it's strawberry girl summer, it's a million other things that you now have to sort of be participating in, rich girl energy, there's a million. It's impossible, and it's all to sell you a lifestyle doesn't exist. And if you unsubscribe from it, if you logged off of social media, that reality would cease to exist. Is what I'm trying to say here, which is all sorts of crazy. We're all just one decision away from a completely different life and more peace of mind. To answer the question, are we our own true selves? I don't know if that's actually possible to know with the amount of influence, money, validation, and fame that is at stake because of social media. Being said, digitally or physically. I don't know if our style is actually who we are because we are influenced so heavily. I don't know if our viewpoints are as strongly held as we actually think they are or if they're just enforced by social media. And what do we own exactly through social media? We don't own our followers. We believe we control our devices with data. Corporations have more control over it. As we integrate technology into our lives, we sacrifice privacy and we're controlled by the data of the devices that are collected against us through advertisements. So feel free to take a break this summer. Get off Instagram if you feel like you need to disconnect and if you feel like you're not in control. For me and other creators, it's especially hard because the internet is our livelihood in many ways. But I think it's interesting to reflect on this prompt. I'm really happy that Harry brought this up because I've been spending time writing about it, even just looking into my own life and what I like about life. And something I really enjoy is the wabi-sabi lifestyle. And wabi-sabi is the Japanese art of impermanence. It's taken from the Japanese words wabi, which translates to less is more, and sabi, which means attentive melancholy. It refers to the awareness of the transient nature of earthly things. It's just about things not needing to be perfect and that it all passes away at some point, which I feel like is a religiously held belief. Personally, I was thinking about the things that I'm really attached to in terms of consumerism, like what is going to be really hard for me to disconnect from. Social media is probably my biggest one. My hair, I think that I'm very emotional when it comes to my hair. And having a home. And as many of you know, this is my first apartment by myself, this apartment that I have in the West Village, and I really love it. I'm very attached to having a home. That said, I don't think many people know that I've moved 20 times in my life. 20 times, which is pretty crazy. My parents just decided to move upsize, downsize to different homes, all pretty much within Maricopa County to find a home that they wanted to live in. I don't know to this day why we've moved 20 times. I thought we were in the witness protection program at one point, not the case, but that was really hard for me. And I read an article recently that said moving is one of the top most traumatic events that can happen to you. So if you've ever moved, I know how hard that is. It was so sad. Every time I would move from a different place, I'd try to like write my initials somewhere in the house because of all the memories that I had there. And I'm really a nostalgic person, really attached to past events, to family, to people even in my family that I didn't even know. As you know, I hunted down a table from my family's lineage and brought it back to New York. So I'm super nostalgic. And moving from place to place honestly probably was pretty traumatic, but in some ways on a positive side, it's probably allowed me to release and let go of things a little bit easier. I think thinking thoughtfully about how you consume, what you consume, and what is in your house. For example, everything that I have in my home now is something I can point to and have a story behind. So for example, my coffee table, my friend Melta made and brought in here. This couch I got off Facebook Marketplace and I drove all the way up to upstate New York and we picked it up in like this place that looked like it was Bruce Wayne's manor and there was dew rolling off the farm. It was really odd. It's a crazy story, but it adds to the lore of your life and it's nice to have pieces that all have beautiful stories behind them. So how does that lead into Eurosummer? So I talked about Eurosummer in the beginning of the show. And Eurosummer is that time of the year when you see everyone's Instagram feed and it's full of vacation pictures, it's full of people getting married, and you're so confused. You're like, how can this person possibly be in Saint-Tropez for 2 months? How is this person here? And what I have to say is comparison is the thief of joy. And you are going to see people out doing this and social media is fake and you do not need to be buying into these things. Even though I know it feels so hard because when I first moved to New York City, I had no friends, not any friends at all, no connections, no one. No one I knew from the Southwest and no money. I was broke and I sat inside my apartment and I watched everyone else have fun. I had met from work and other things, and it was just really hard because I had no one to go with and no money to go anywhere. I would first like to say, turn off your phone, try to just do 1 to 2 hours of phone time. Try to do things every day in New York City or with your family or within the country that are pretty affordable and cheap. I personally found some really great glamping places over by the Redwoods that were like $100 less a night, and that's so beautiful. Like, go make your own adventure if you don't have enough money to fly across to Italy or do one of those things. There's a lot of opportunities now to make your own little adventure. Remember, comparison is the thief of joy. You will get there one day if you do want to get there, but don't stress yourself out. I'm continuing on this trend of this week in tech, and I'm adding culture into this week. So I did a little rundown last week. I hope you enjoyed it. We're gonna do it again this week. So this week, Justin Timberlake was arrested in Sag Harbor. This has been the biggest story. I don't feel bad for Justin Timberlake, honestly. The internet is rejoicing, and I sort of feel like this kicked off summer, like this got people hype. Getting arrested after having one drink in the Hamptons, sure it was one drink, but this man, for real, has a ton of money. Why are you driving? Why are you driving? I feel like him and J-Lo, people are coming for them really hard because they have not been the nicest people to others, and I feel like karma's coming back for them. Kicked off summer. Charlie XCX, if you are a Gen Z person, you're gonna get this. If you're not, you probably don't even know this is going on. Charlie XCX launched her new album. It is officially Brat Summer. All the pop girlies are really having a moment right now. Rita Carpenter, Charlie XCX, Olivia Rodrigo, Chappell Roan, Lana Del Rey, Billie Eilish, Tyla, Renee Rapp, Tate McRae, all crushing it. They're out of control this summer. It's so fun to watch. And then recently, the Princess of Wales, Kate Middleton, appeared in public again. She's not dead for the conspiracy theorists that thought she was dead. And we got a little surprise appearance from Prince Louis, who was dancing. So cute. He is really funny. And then Princess Charlotte is giving like Hermione Granger vibes up there. She's I don't know if anyone saw it, but she was kind of like scolding him to stop dancing, and she just feels very proper, like a little mom. I love that Kate Middleton did not stop him from being himself. It seems like she really loves him for who he is. Of course, I know it's his mother, but it's also just like, you know, the British family can be very cold and sterile, and she's allowing him to be himself, and I think that's great. What else happened this week? In crypto, DJT launched. So DJT was a Solana token that people were assuming was associated with Donald Trump, who the former president running for president again. It spiked dramatically after it spread. Statement came out today on the 20th that there is no association, though Scully vehemently swears that there is and that he's BFFs with Barron Trump, who allegedly is the person behind the token. None of this seems to be true. It also feels like people would be going to jail if it was true, so this is all very stupid in my opinion. And then Michael Saylor acquires 11.9 thousand more Bitcoin for $786 million. The company now owns 226,331 Bitcoin. That's just shy of $15 billion. Insane. You can't even begin to understand how large that is. That's this week's show. I hope you enjoyed. Thanks for tuning in. If you would like to share this episode with a friend, please do. Make sure you like it, like the show, give it a good review, and if you'd like to sponsor us, you can email us at theobservation@gmail.com. I hope everyone has a great week, and I will talk to you soon. Bye.